So the reason people think that weight loss surgery is really the only durable and effective treatment for weight is that obviously doctors have been recommending diet and exercise forever. And they're very important for people. Diet and exercise are obviously good things. But the problem is only about maybe 5% of people can lose a significant amount of weight through diet and exercise and keep it off long term. That's what the problem is. It's the keeping it off, and the surgery helps with that. So there are different weight categories, and one of the ways we do that is through body mass index, which is not a perfect way to define somebody's weight and health, but it's the best thing that we have. It's based on essentially a calculation of height and weight. So if a body mass index between 20 and 25 is considered normal. Something above 25 up to 30 is considered overweight. So if you get into a body mass index above 30, then you're considered obese. And then there are different classifications of obesity. So classically, if you have a body mass index of 40 or greater, you qualify as having clinically severe obesity. It's also true at a BMI of 35 as long as you have some severe associated medical problem like diabetes or sleep apnea. We occasionally have patients who qualify for weight loss surgery with a body mass index of 40 who happen not to have any other associated medical problems. I would say that's rare. Most of our patients have a big long list of medical problems, and that would be things like high cholesterol, high blood pressure, joint problems. Diabetes is very common among obese patients, sleep apnea. There are many, many things, and depression, I would say, goes along with weight in a lot of our patients. So generally speaking, it's unusual to be clinically severely obese and not have associated medical problems. But even for those patients, the weight predisposes them to having medical problems later. So even without current medical problems, there's still a good reason to have weight loss surgery. So there are a couple of different ways to think about the costs of this surgery, and people who have studied it look at it on a sort of population base. And what we know is that it costs a lot of money to take care of the medical problems that go along with weight. And so the people who have studied this have found that a patient who has weight loss surgery, within 2 to 4 years, the costs of taking care of them health-wise will be less than they would have been filling prescriptions, going to the doctor, having other operations. So basically, this is something that pays for itself in a couple years, which is really important for insurers to know and for employers to know, because this is an operation that's making people healthier. I think a lot of people have a misconception that weight loss surgery is risky surgery. And what our national database has shown recently is that weight loss surgery is now as safe as gallbladder surgery, which is amazing because most people wouldn't think twice. If their doctor said they needed to have their gallbladder out, they wouldn't concern themselves too much about the risk because they would know it was something they needed to do for their health. Well, this is absolutely true about weight loss surgery as well. It's now gotten to be a very safe set of procedures. And so, honestly, the risk to patients carrying the weight and having those medical problems is greater than the risk from having the surgery itself. In order to be successful after weight loss surgery, you do need to make significant lifestyle changes. And most programs that offer weight loss surgery have you go through a 3 to 6 month program of education so you know how to take care of yourself both before and after the surgery. So our patients learn a lot. They learn about how to shop, how to cook, how to read a label. What are good choices? They learn about calories and the different kinds of calories. They learn a lot about exercise and also about family dynamics. So there's a lot that patients have to do to get ready for the surgery so that they can do the right things afterwards.